This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. How will you be driving in the future? And, well, depending on your age, the not-so-distant future. We are joined by Joe Coughlin from MIT's Age Lab. Thanks for being with us.
It's great to be here. Thank you.
So you've got some amazing cars that you've fitted with all sorts of computers. First of all, why should we be worried about how the elderly drive?
Well, in many ways, we shouldn't be worried about how the elderly drive, and we really should be worried about how those with poor health conditions drive. You know, birthdays don't kill, but health conditions, medications, and the combination of different diseases and different drugs actually can lead to a problem. So what we're doing here at the MIT Age Lab and with the U.S. Department of Transportation's Transportation Center is we're developing new technologies to detect driver state, how well you're doing behind the wheel, both physically, physiologically, as well as performance at any age.
Okay, so what are some of the gadgets that you have in the car that are watching or monitoring me as the driver?
Well, if you think about it, the car is about to change in a great way that we've never anticipated. You know, for a matter of 40, 50 years, the car was high style, high design, but still was at its heart a mechanical engineering wonder. But today and tomorrow, the car is where computer science and mechanical engineering collide, if you will, and create a car that's going to be sensitive to how you feel behind the wheel. So imagine a system that's going to maybe adjust for your feeling fatigued, perhaps being stressed, or indeed, as we talk about more and often these days, distracted, and maybe pump up the air conditioning to bring you down if you're feeling a little stressed. Maybe even using different aroma or scent, if you will, to wake you up if you're fatigued and indeed distracted.
So now, how is it going to get all these readings from my body? Are we talking about the same little handles that I have on the exercise machines at the gym that are measuring my pulse and whether I'm sweating or not? What are you reading?
Well, you know, the best technology is the technology that's invisible and works as I believe it was Arthur Clarke once said, like magic. And so the car is going to have a number of sensors. We're going to have eye tracking that'll track your eyes. What are you looking at? With what duration? Are you looking around to show that A, you're awake, and B, you're paying attention? Will there be sensors? And in fact, there will be, both in the steering wheel and maybe in the seat, maybe in the seatbelt, to detect little things like, I don't know, are your hands sweaty, showing that you're stressed? Is your pulse rate going up and down? Are you paying attention to the warning systems that the car of today has, but may create more problems for you, particularly as we age tomorrow?
Is there more of an emphasis on this today because the baby boomers are retiring in larger numbers?
Well, there's two things going on. The baby boomers or the Donkai in Japan or wherever you might be talking about are retiring in greater numbers, but they've had more experience with technology than any previous generation. They've got greater expectations. And despite the economic downturn, they still are the ones who buy the premium car with a high tech, high style, and indeed, high price tag. This is not going to be your grandfather or father's generation. I believe that baby boomers are going to demand to drive longer because, frankly, particularly here in the United States, 70% of us, and I'm at the tail end, live where public transportation either does not serve at all, as in does not exist, or serve well, that is the suburbs and rural area. But there's something else going on. This is the first generation of women who work in very large numbers, have more education than any previous generation of women, and are less likely to be happy staying home. So between expectations, education, and frankly where they live, I think you're going to see baby boomers out there on the road far longer than their parents and grandparents.
And how far away are we from seeing one of these aware cars in a showroom?
Technology is moving far faster in the vehicle than we've ever seen before. So you're not going to see it all at once. You're going to see pieces starting to come out in the next year and over the next 5 to 10 years. And frankly, with one baby boomer in the United States turning 65, one every 7 seconds, we don't have time to make this into a research project. The time is now.
Joe Coughlin from the Age Lab at MIT. Thanks so much for joining us today.
Thanks so much. It's a pleasure talking with you.
This is The Rundown. I'm Hari Srinivasan. Stay with us.